it's an okay wing. I've got to be honest. Right.
The barbecue's very nice.
I don't know how much I'm going to eat there. I do like chicken wings, but at the same time, I don't think I can eat chicken wings all day. Maybe I could, do it. I feel like I need something to line the stomach, because I've eaten nothing, I've had a coffee, and the problem is, when I'm hungry, I get cranky. So I just need to eat something, just something easy. There it is, look at that, man, told you. There's a fog lights upstairs. Is it on? I'll let them go first, because then I don't look like the fat cut.
What's the plan today?
So I suppose it's a better start, but I'll say thanks to Matt. So thanks to Matt for Food & Brew Club. Invited us down today to experience Wingfest. I've never been here before. I haven't heard a lot about it, but probably because I'm not a big like food world kind of news guy. It's supposed to be the bee's knees. It's supposed to be good. Arguably, they're meant to be the biggest wing festival in the world, I think. In the world, yeah. I think they run four, like one in London, one in Birmingham, one in, I want to say, Derby or Rugby, somewhere like that. So yeah, Matt's invited us down today to come and just experience today. There's entertainment, you know, beer, wings, etc, etc. And I plan to get my day's worth. It's a plan. So I'm going to eat as much chicken as I humanly can. Without, you know, swelling to the size of a balloon and being unable to drive on. So that's the plan. I'm quite excited to try some spicy wings. I like spice, man. So I'm excited to give some spicy wings a go. We'll see. Admittedly, we are already in Five Guys. We started the day the way we mean to go on. Do you know what I mean? We started it well. So bacon cheese dog. What have you gone for? A burger? But you had no cheese yet. You had a bacon burger. I mean, I could do that. I can't be having cheese in my burger. So yeah, bacon cheese dog, just to start the day. And then we're off to Wingfest. No. We shouldn't be saying it all. Do we not remember what I ordered? A bacon cheese dog.
Yeah.
With jalapenos, ketchup and mustard. Now, I'm not going to lie. It's a funny fucking looking ketchup mustard, because I can see lettuce, I can see pickle, I can see mayo. All right. It might be deja vu.
Number two.
It's because it is. That's me, that's you. Okay, now, this time, this isn't my normal order. My normal order is a bacon cheeseburger, jalapenos and hot sauce, a large fries, and a bacon cheese dog. But today I've not gone for the fries or the burger, just the cheese dog. It's upside down, but we have jalapenos, cheese, mustard and ketchup. That's all, and bacon.
Simple.
Oh. I'm happy now.
There you go.
Oh man. I feel like, dumb as it sounds, I feel like walking into the sun. Hold on, I'm already cooking. This isn't built for sun. This is built for like minus 40 winters in the Viking fucking lands, do you know what I mean? We'll have a go. Right, okay. Oh, you spin it. She never said she's been. She spins it. That's a rig! So say it now. Well, the way her wrist game works, I wouldn't let her wank me off. That was fucking dreadful. Did you see that? What was that? Nah, mate. It says £5 for a spin. Does it say £5 so I can spin you? I'm fucking in disbelief. I've been here 5 minutes, I've been mugged off. Bastards. Right, unimpressed already. I can't believe she spent it, she can. I'm in disbelief. I paid £5 so she can spin it.
Yes.
Let me decide my own fate, man. Where in the terms and conditions does it say you spin for me? Right, I'm making a big deal out of it now, so I'm going to stop. But just know I'm really angry inside.
Yeah, man. Are you good?
Yeah.
Making it all right, yeah?
Yeah, man, it was all right. Not too bad.
Hello, bro. How are you? Are you good?
Yeah, you good.
Nice to meet you. Ready some fucking wings or what?
I mean, yeah, but I'm going to be... Bro, I just walked in. He says £5 for a spin on the wheel. I said, yeah, safe. I've had a fiver. Why does she spin it for me? Like this?
What?
Fuck off. Am I paying you a fiver? Let me spin the wheel. And obviously, she landed on nothing, so I got nothing. And then we got here and got in the Stratford centre and I went, so Five Guys here. And he went there.
And how many Five Guys did you have, mate?
We had two. They got it wrong, you know. Yeah. They got the first order wrong, but let us keep it.
Oh, look, they've got the camera on. Five Guys. Let's settle the debate. Do you rate Burger King?
No, I hate it.
I think it's the worst.
It's the most washed burger place.
It's the worst.
Yeah, there it is. That, like, it's like they suck any bit of moisture that exists in life
and flavour
out of that burger. It's so dry, the meat has no flavour. Oh, it's horrible. I hate it. No, I agree with you.
Where are they
awful.
Eating?
It's awful.
The service station ones are though, even worse.
Yeah, because they... Oh, they
put
even...
them together with a catapult. That'll do. That'll do.
So
the best wing. The best. This is like the British fucking the champion.
Okay.
Whoever wins this gets to fucking dine out on it for next year. So currently, Gertwing's the number one.
That's what I was going to say. Is last year's number one here? Gertwing, yeah. Is that why everyone's queuing?
Around there. Slows. We'll go for Wonder.
I'm thinking Buffalo. You know. Buffalo sounds like more like a little bit of scramble.
Are you Buffalo?
I mean, I like. Have a good run, guys. I like spice.
Yep.
I like ranch. It's got both. So, for me, that's a winner. Buffalo and barbecue.
Correct.
I've got to go Buffalo.
Josh, is this your first official review, bro?
This is my first, yeah, what?
George, you've got to go scores out of 10.
All right.
Details, specifics, textures, taste. Let's go. Come on, bro. Show us how it's done.
You're talking to someone who just eats anything?
Yeah, I know, but this, you've got to elevate your game now. You're on YouTube, bro.
Right.
This baked
presentation, I mean, I'm going to give a presentation is very good.
It looks pretty, doesn't it?
I'm going to give it like an 8 out of 10 for presentation.
Ooh,
start.
We've got scores just for presentation.
Yeah. Wow. I'm going to give that. I'm going to say it feels slightly soggy, which I don't like. So I can tell you, but if it's baked, it should be more crispy. It feels slightly soggy. So I'm going to question the amount of time I've spent baking it.
Question the amount of time I've spent baking it.
And then I'm going to. So, if you come with me, I know a little shop called Dixie Chicken. We can get four litres for £1.
Yeah.
No, I'm serious. We can. We can get four for
not
£1.
To this. No, but also, look, we've got Big Boy Bake, mincing about, chewing it.
You're welcome. That was impressive. I'm not gonna lie.
Do you think you can do that?
No, I'm in control.
That was quite impressive.
Right, overall, score. Baked bird, chicken fry. This is just me, by the way. I know I'm with Matt, but Matt's not included in this.
You're your own man, mate. Give your own score.
I'm going to go with, like a 6.
6.
Oh, I can spin this
one. There we go.
Don't break it. It's all right, down there, I wasn't allowed to spin it.
You weren't.
No, it's not for me.
I'm
actually allowed to spin this one. I don't need a babysitter for the world. So, which way can I go, left or right? Demand.
Either way.
Good God. Right. Spin again.
Oh. Go on, give it another go. Spin again.
That's now.
We've just got the official nod from Gert Wings. We can go, we can canoe jump. Sorry, everyone. Part of the job, privilege.
I mean, I'm not going to moan.
Right, he's doing his own reviews today. Yeah. Baked Bird, they got a 6 out of 10. I think that was a bit of a push for him as well, to be fair. So we're hoping we can beat a 6. Can we beat a 6 today?
I think we can.
He's a Dixie Chicken man, so we've got a tough work to go here.
Let's go. Let's do it.
Look at that. Woo! So your criticism of the last one was a bit soft, right? Look at that.
Nah, I see. Right, no, that's a win, yeah. There we go. I'm impressed.
Come on, bro. Oh, my God, the smell.
I'm not going to lie.
It's all in the coating.
Is that a little drum, is it? Oh, it is.
Boy, look at this. Look how hard that is.
Do you want to see how hard this is?
No, I'm joking.
Oh, hold on.
This. It's degrading the channel, bro. Come on, there's children watching. Get this round your lips.
Right.
Here we go. Holy shit.
All right.
Fucking hell.
There's no point eating anything else.
How fucking good is that? But you can see, coming nice and closer, you can see, look how crispy that is. It's like rock solid, no oil on it, it's not falling apart. The sauce is sat on top perfectly. Ooh. Technically speaking, these are the best wings in the country.
There you go.
That is immaculate.
Would you agree?
Well.
Everything about an Indian wing.
Tell everyone about your wing.
Yeah.
What was it?
So it's coated in, it's soaked in buttermilk and Indian spices, then taken out. Then it's got a tandoori coated dredge, which is why you get the red coating on the outside. And then we've got a mango curried sauce on top with a mint grater, nigella seeds, and poppadoms on the side.
So are they baked or fried?
Fried.
I mean, I've just had baked, and the batter was just falling off. It was no crisp at all. It was soggy. But the fact that these are fried and they're keeping that level of crisp, that's unreal. I could go out now. I honestly, that isn't real.
And this is the champion, right?
That's the champion.
This is the champion one.
Mate, that is phenomenal. Phenomenal. Oh my God.
Kim? Buffalo and blue cheese.
Good one, ain't ya? This is the champion wing.
That.
The last.
Oh, yes.
The last green
light. I'm quite excited. I'm very excited, I'm not going to lie to you, mate. This is the champion wing. So what's this?
Buffalo
and cheese.
Okay. Soaked, it's our original recipe. We've been using it for 6 years.
Yep.
Soaked in buttermilk, loads of different spices, about 11 different herbs
and
spices.
All of the wild wing stuff, like the Indian, they're all good. They're exciting, but this is the bread and butter, right?
It looks unreal.
This is your bench press.
Yeah.
This is the one that everyone gives a shit about, right?
Yeah.
Nobody cares how much you can calf raise.
When we started, that was the only one on our menu.
Was it?
Oh,
it looks immaculate.
Cheers.
I want to go.
Cheers, bro.
You just have to fiddle about a bit and then it can stop.
That's next level.
I've never had food that makes me laugh. That is
the best. The sauce makes your face come alive.
I'm a mess. I don't care.
Worth it.
I need the cameraman to try one. Come on, bro. You're gonna get messy, aren't you? Good enough.
Mate, there is.
Pretty cool.
It is pretty cool. I mean, I didn't know wings were such a. People are passionate about their wings.
You probably can't hear a thing, but what are you eating now?
Definitely not. So we're trying poor boys. We're getting four of everything. They do apparently a buffalo wing that's topped with Cheetos. So. We'll see. We don't know yet, but we'll see. Is that chocolate?
Yeah.
Oh my God. Right. That looks fucking mental. I'm going to eat that chicken so we don't fall.
Now, I've got a sneaky suspicion this might be his favourite. At Derby, this was my favourite. Now, the other one we just had is like the classic high level, but I think this has got a little bit something extra. It's all your personal taste though, right?
Go on. I've been eating that all day long. All day long. Cheese sauce. Cheetos.
About the bread.
How was that?
I'm sorry, but I just stood there saying, we ain't gonna beat that all day. I moved 10 feet. That is unreal. Oh my God.
And now you got dessert. Cinnamon one.
That's what I love about Reaper.
The fucking chocolate
wings. And then you go and have another one.
It shouldn't work. It shouldn't work, but it will.
I don't know. I'm skeptical here. I don't think it's gonna work. I don't think it's working.
It's good. It's good.
Why is it good?
Oh, yeah.
It is. Why is it good?
You know what?
Put your plates away. Put your shit in the bin.
Yep, I agree. We're gonna give four boys a rating. That was a 10.
That's it. Right. Little inside scoop for everyone. Technically, in a lot of people's, you've just had some, maybe the best two. You've got Wingman's down there, he's very good. But I want to take you now to an outsider who I think could be the best.
Really?
Yeah. I'm piling on the pressure here.
Mate, I don't see anything beating that buffalo we know just had from there.
I think I might be able to give you something different now.
Mate, they put chocolate on it and it tasted good.
That's funny.
So,
if you haven't subscribed to this channel, by the way, what the fuck are you doing?
I agree.
Have a look at yourself. Come on. It's getting into food now.
I agree.
Food this week, horse riding next week. Let's go.
Well, I'd love to see you on a horse.
I can hold my weight, mate. That.
What do you think the weight limit is on that?
You reckon that can hold me? Or?
Oh, yeah. He's
I'm there for a second, fly off somewhere, and end up ruining someone's wingspan. Been brilliant.
There are 37 in the buffalo category, sorry, in the wild wing category. There are 33 in the buffalo category, and there are 15 in the barbecue category. Barbecue category is new to this year. So this is a London Wing Fest, which is the largest chicken wing festival in the world. And we're here to find out who does the best wings in the country, basically. We divide it up into three categories: best wild wing, best buffalo wing, best barbecue wing. Today is the judges' vote. We've got six judges roaming. They're gonna try every single wing. Tomorrow is the people's vote. If you scan the QR codes around the area, it will bring up a list of all the traders, and then you choose who is your favourite trader, and then tomorrow we announce who is the winner of the people's vote. The winner of both the judges and the people's can go on to big things. It's the difference between going from street food to a restaurant, from going from a restaurant to 10 restaurants. It can get you investment, so it's a big deal. But everybody here sells wicked, wicked wings, so if you like wings, it's a place to be.
Hmm? What's on this one?
I don't know. I truly have no idea. We are yet to find out. I'm quite excited, actually. I know that I'm enjoying. I mean, it's gradually got better all the way. I've only had three. So, what have I had? Baked, then we had Gertwing, and then we had Poor Boys at the minute.
So far?
Poor Boys is top in the list. Gert is a close second, but Poor Boys is. I mean, that buffalo wing was. Ooh. Jesus Christ, that was good.
Actually, a bone marrow buffalo. We've got a blue cheese ranch. We've got. Beef dripping popcorn with dried
beef
chives
dripping popcorn
and salt.
Can we try just one bit of popcorn?
Yeah.
So we've got ginger wings, and I think we've got, yeah, so that is the bone marrow buffalo, which is cowboy blue cheese, beef dripping, and chive popcorn. Beef dripping and chive popcorn?
Yes.
That's right, I didn't say it wrong, you heard me.
Yeah.
Beef dripping and chive popcorn. And then we've also got same but different, which is lemongrass and soy caramel, Penang mayo, spring onion, chili prawn cracker, crispy onion, pickled cucumber. Now, I'm not going to lie.
It's quite a mouthful.
I'm not like a soy caramel guy kind of thing. Not a big like fan of that. So I don't know if that's going to be for me. But the bone marrow buffalo sounds up my street. It's talking my language. So we should start with, at a minimum, the bone marrow buffalo, which, now I'm not going to lie, I don't want to offend anyone here because I am new to this world, don't forget, but they all look the same. As in terms of the buffaloes, well, I'm assuming they're Gnukas, they're buffalo wings. It's more just about looking for the flavour difference. So maybe I'm just stupid, which I am, forget it. Beef dripping popcorn. Sounds a bit, I don't know. There's only one way to find out. So, this is the bone marrow buffalo.
Where are we at?
First thing to report as well, they're smaller. Much smaller, little diddy wings. Sometimes the meat's a bit softer on a smaller wing. Fucking delicious. Premier.
Feels healthier.
It does. Bone marrow buffalo.
How much of it's in my beard?
Nah. Oh, good. It's part of the job, though.
Yeah, now I'm not going to lie.
What's the verdict on this one?
Hey, don't rush him. He's thinking. He's in a gogs on him.
See?
He really thinks, doesn't he? He's like, he sort of stares like this.
I'm just letting the... I'm letting the flavours come alive. And what I've got now.
It's subtle. The one thing I thought, the chicken was nice and tender as well.
The chicken,
soft.
The quality of the chicken was probably the best I've had yet. However, it comes second to poor boys. It comes second just about to poor boys.
That he had a spicy cheese on that.
And not just that, but the crisp of the wing was so good. I mean, I'm going to go again because I've got...
There's the smaller wings as well. Sometimes when I went to America once, they have these fucking genetically modified pterodactyl wings. They're huge and they're so tough. Sometimes the smaller wing is sweeter and like easier to eat. You can have twice the amount, it's not like you're getting less meat. It's nice,
I'm eating bones. I'm gonna eat it as well. I'm gonna eat that bone, I'm not spitting it out.
You eating bones?
I am.
Jim Reaper eats bones. He's eating bones.
I can't be asked to spit it out. I got it. Right, yeah, second.
Now, this is the wild card. Have you seen these yet?
So,
this is your wild card here.
I've read something about a Penang Mayola soy caramel.
Yeah.
Now, for me, number one, I hate pickled anything. That's got pickled cucumber on.
Yeah.
So that's a no for me already, but.
Take it off.
I'm gonna take it off.
Yeah, if you take that one off, look. Flick that one off, you've got this one on the end here, that's got none on it.
You know what, we'll just go there.
There you go.
Right. So, this is the lemongrass, Penang mayo, soy caramel, with...
Looks sexy though, it's got layers to it.
Chili, spring onion, and crispy onion.
And he dusted it up with...
No, he did dust it up.
With a salt as well, yeah.
Some sort of like, I don't know what it was, like a pink salt.
Sort of Korean salt. This should have layers to it.
So, I'm excited for this because it's not a buffalo wing, so I can expect something new.
Right, to all you people that have subscribed to the channel, cheers. Right, the out goes in.
I'm going to be honest with you. That out does the buffalo for me.
Yeah. The out goes in is so thin and clean.
That, yeah, I did not think I'd like that.
That's the wing you could have 25 of.
This one. Yeah.
Wing of the day is still that poor boy's buffalo.
Yeah.
For me. I suppose that'll take the buffalo category for me so far. But as an outsider, non-buffalo, that is very good. Very good. And it was kind of layered almost in terms of texture and then flavour. Off the rip you had like a sweet caramel. And then as you got a bit in, you could taste your onion. Obviously just herbs in that chicken. It was nice, bro. It was actually nice. I genuinely enjoyed that. And I didn't think I'd like it when I read it. I thought I'm not gonna enjoy that wing and I did, so. Shows that you shouldn't shut things out, do you know what I mean?
I like
try
it.
Everything. Do you ever get like that when you wear a hat?
Yeah.
You had it on, like, I don't have a hat anymore. But you know, when you've got a hairline like mine, you need to wear a hat. So it's like, I fucked either way, you know? How much, mate?
Don't break it, all right?
Don't break it, yeah? There we go, thank you. First time, what can I say? I'm a natural, thank you.
What do you reckon? Matt, I might try this, all right? I might try this one. Good man. I just said the spice is overpowering the ranch as well. Yeah, and it's got that ranch on with blue cheese, and it just mixes well.
You can eat 15 of them.
Yeah. I'm happy with that. That was bad boy. Gary, you own, I'm assuming bones, yeah?
Yeah.
Own bones, yours.
Own bones, yeah.
Right. So I was walking past. I said to him, some of the mates was calling me in, so we came, and I said already today, so we've had poor boys, Gert wings, no, what did we have first? We had baked first, then Gert wings, then poor boys, then we tried ginger wings, then you.
Yeah.
Now, I'm not going to lie, best buffalo I've had,
mate.
Beat both of them, mate. And you know what it was? We've got Gert and we've poor boys, yeah. There's a lot going on. There is a lot going on. It gets to the point sometimes where there's too much going on. It's perfect.
Because it's simple, we smoke the chilies ourselves. And
Right blend of everything, mate. Blue cheese, the complement of blue cheese was just right. You just had that right hint of the chili, that right hint of spice, and then the soundness and creaminess of that blue cheese was just unreal, mate. Cheers, seriously, mate. Adding it, well done. That's my wing of the day so far.
Cheers, mate.
All right, mate, thank you. Legend.
This is Conor McGregor's. Right,
so yeah, Conor McGregor's stout.
Don't you know him?
I believe this is the competitor to Guinness. Now, I'm not going to lie, I might upset a few viewers here, but I'm not a Guinness fan. However, I might be a Forge Irish Stout fan. That's quite nice.
Yeah, how are you?
It's fucking hot. I mean, look, I don't complain a lot. And I'm assuming by now you know that was sarcastic, because I do. I complain a lot. I'm going to complain again. It's too fucking hot. Alright. I just got back from Turkey. It was 38, 40 there, 45 some days. I didn't feel this fucking hot. Why is the sun in the UK like a magnifying glass of a fucking ant? Why? Do you know what I mean? I'm dying. I don't want to eat a wing. Oh, in fact, where's the nearest snow dome?
Yes.
Thank you, man.
What's your name? Hello, how are you?
Alright, where are we going now?
Jim Reaper on a bucking Bronco.
Can you fucking imagine it?
What's the weight limit on that thing?
I'd ride that all day. Fucking hell.
Pretty busy.
Like, wings were such a good thing. Wing lab. Now, some say I was made in a lab. What I'm finding, a lot of these places don't have queues, and a lot of them do. And I feel like I want to try all the ones without a queue, because they need love too.
Yep.
Do you know what I mean? A two wild wing Thai,
yeah,
two buffalo wing. So nice one, I've been a sriracha.
Sriracha. I wanted to say sriracha.
That's why we've blended sriracha. Honey and lime, sauce chicken, topped with crispy shallots, fresh chili, sesame seeds, and cupi mayo. It is their signature ring, so we'll see. I mean, look, like I said, got to try everywhere, got to give it a go. We've already gone buffalo again because, I mean, we've got to try all the buffaloes. I already know that, just being realistic and slightly vivid with you here, the shit I'm going to have tonight might be the craziest shit of my life. But we invest, that's what we're investing in. We're investing in that experience of shitting. So stay tuned. Buffalo 2, got two more buffalo coming up. I'm going to eat a lot of buffalo today. I'm a bit concerned. In fact, I need to fart. Done. Okay. We're going to go bin top like we do. I'm seeing similarities everywhere. There's going to be, because it's buffalo, yeah? So already, I know I'm going to show you this again, but you've seen this about 9 times already today. Looks like every buffalo wing you've had. I think that's one of the takeaways from me so far, as a new foodie that I am. Where's the uniqueness? You know what I mean? Like the Cheeto top one over there was unique. Might not have been the best wing I've had all day. Probably was. Now, the more I think of it, the more it's coming back as being the best. But it was unique. They're all the same. This, however, quite excited for. Wild wing Thai time. I'm going to go in with this first. So, I just spat, sorry. Apologies, guys. This is the Wing Lab Wild Wing Thai Time. That was a vivid experience. So, off the rip,
there was a sweetness and then a hint of spice. Sriracha kicked in quite quickly and maintained throughout the whole bite, but there was also a sourness that kicked in afterward, a weird sourness. It might have been the lime or the QB mayo, but it kicked in, then got sour, then went back to a sweet chili. That was bizarre. That was like sex in my mouth. Right. The more that I've had that, the better that's got. Now, quite spicy. I can deal with spice, it's fine. But that sweet kick to it is fucking gorgeous. That has just taken, yet again, that's the number one spot for non-buffalo.
Shit.
Non-buffalo, that is the best one I've had today. Now, halfway through that first bite, I pulled that face, I was a bit unsure. But it redeemed itself. It's like the flavours swapped and indulged and it came back to life again. Bizarre. I'm a fan. I'm going to keep that one for you if you'd like to try it.
Absolutely.
We're now going in with the buffalo, the classic, yeah, what we're here for, really. What is this buffalo we've had so far? We've done poor boys, goat wings, baked, we've done ginger, we've done bones. So we've done about 5 or 6 already. Can it live up to the hype? We shall see. Going in with the buffalo at Wing Lab. Mid. Super mid. Blue cheese was underwhelming. They could barely taste it. The buffalo sauce wasn't spicy at all. There was no spice at all. Like, and I don't know if it's maybe I had pre-spice, but there was nothing in there that came out of me. Got bland. Oh well. Wing Lab. You might have won Wing of the Day for non-buffalo, but buffalo is poor rent. The running theme is obviously buffalo again. But I've got one called Parchita, or Parchita, who knows? I'll be Parchitting later, I know that much, but I've got one called Parchita, which is habanero and passion fruit with ranch. Fine. Sounds weirdly nice. Yeah, we're going for that. You know what I'm going to do? I'm not going to get no buffalo. I'm going to go for that. Just two of them. One thing I've just noticed, these are skin-on barbecue wings. So this may be a nice pleasant surprise. I'm quite excited now. Okay. What's it called? Yeah. Like I said, later I'll be taking big parchitas. So we've got parchita. I don't know. What, habanero passion with ranch. A wild card, I suppose. We've not gone buffalo because I feel like I've had enough buffalo now. I'm not gonna lie, my stomach feels like a wild lab at the minute. Fucking hell, it's bubbling. So we're gonna go with this bad boy now. It's habanero, which is probably a worse idea. You know what I mean? Like, I'm talking about not being buffalo, and then here I am with the habanero, so. Now it smells very good. No. It's a no from me. They are like quality of the wings has been that, if you ask me. Not only that, but there's no passion fruit there at all. There's no passion fruit at all. It's just spice. It's overwhelming spice, it's too much. There's no passion fruit. There's nothing else there. It's just like putting chili sauce in your mouth. It's best I can put it. Want to try one?
I'm good.
I wouldn't.
Yeah.
Well, I need a shit.
It's the Jim Reaper!
Mate, hello, you alright?
Very well, mate. What's been your favourite wing so far?
Oh, mate, it's a tough question, you know. It's hard to be. So far, to the rest. I love your shot. Doritos in the batter. Come on for me. saying these are the best.
There you go.
Look at that there, something different, right? Blackcurrant. Oh, mate, that's good. Good? Good wing, mate. They know what they're doing. It'll be the wing reaper soon. Lock up your fucking chickens.
Remember to wash your hands, guys. Keep the beer clean.
Back, Callum, old Jess. Oh, he's still got a bit left, Callum. Now, Callum's the winner!
Fancy you go on that?
Hello, guys. So, we are just leaving now, Wingfest London. I would say it's been a success. As a non-food reviewer, you know, an avid gym goer, but a content creator overall, it's been fun. However, you ready? I'm going to say it. Once you've had one, you've had them all. I mean, a buffalo wing is a buffalo wing. A lot of them taste pretty similar. A lot of them taste pretty much the same. There were some standouts, poor boys, Gerwings, and Bones. You guys stood out amazingly. Buffalo from Bones was top notch. That was the one for me. That was the wing of the day. It was Bones, Buffalo. Overall, it's cool. I'll definitely go to Wingfest in Birmingham. I think I'll probably not be able to enjoy myself today as much as I wanted to, because I've driven 2.5 hours here and I'm driving 2.5 hours home. So I've not been able to have a bevy, you know what I mean, and actually like sit down and enjoy myself. The idea of travel sits on your mind all day, so you know, knowing I've got to travel, I've not been able to relax. But overall, it's been good and it's been fun. Thanks to Matt for Food Review Club for getting me in, getting me down here. Thank you to Dan, man behind the camera, legend. And finally, we're going to close out today with this picture of me and Matt from Food Review Club. As you can see, let me just turn this brightness up so you can really see how bad this is. Look how much he's been out angled here. He looks like a small child. Hey, there we go. My forearm's bigger than you, Matt. It's a bit unlucky, isn't it? Right, let's do one.